Okay, so just going to take a look at the Living World Teach and Treat toy for rabbits and small animals. Firstly, on the back here, very sensibly, we've got four sucker pads which will secure the product down to any hard surface. When we flip it over, we see here we've got a casing and we've got eight small holes that can be filled with a variety of treats, pellets, bits of herbs, hay, something that the rabbit enjoys, or vegetables. We're just going to have a look now at what comes with this. So firstly, we have a central panel. We also have a large disc which fits in there to move around. We have, for the more advanced level, we have this which limits the movement of the discs, and we have four of these knobs which very cleverly have a hole in the top so that we can put herbs or hay in there. Okay, so we're going to look at beginner's level one. We're just going to place some small treats, little bits of broken up pellet, a bit of coriander, some spring greens. Now, whatever your bunny likes to eat, but remember that if we're going to be doing this for a little while, it's best to keep the foods low fat. So more veggies and herbs probably recommended than pellets. Okay, a bit more coriander in there. And then we take the large blue disc here and we slot it in so that the disc can be moved around to get to the food. So we're just going to see how that goes. Once the rabbit or small pet has worked out how to do this, you can make it just a little bit more challenging by simply placing less food so that as the holes get unearthed, there may or may not be a treat within them. So now we're going to look at level two, the intermediate level, where the rabbit has to lift knobs to get up to the food underneath. Cleverly, the knobs have holes in them so that we can place a bit of herb. In this case, I'm using some parsley or even some hay. In the holes underneath them, we're going to again pop in some little bit of food, be it herbs, pellets, or even just a strand or two of favourite hay. And then we cover these with the blue knobs, and the bunny has to lift the knobs off in order to get to the food underneath. And we'll just pop the central panel back in there. Once your bunny's got used to how this works, then we can remove the herbs from the top so that the bunny has to smell the food underneath and get to it that way. Also, just simply moving the treats around, putting them in different places, will encourage him or her to look around to get the food. Through training also, clicker training possibly, we can get the rabbit to pick up the blue knobs and put them in a box or something similar, or just drop them down beside. We also have an instruction here that at expert level the pet can place the knobs back in the holes. And so now for level 3, the advanced level. Again, to start, we're just going to place some herbs in the blue knobs here. And in this one, we'll just pop in some couple of strands of hay as well. And then taking the white scent panel, which has a flip-up lid, we'll place that in the centre. The knobs then slide in to the space and can be moved around, but they can't actually just be lifted out. And this is ingenious, because this means that your rabbit has to move the blue knobs around to get to the food. So then underneath we place the little bits of treats or vegetables, whatever you want to use, and cover them up with the knobs. And then the bunny has to move the discs, the knobs rather, around in order to get to the food underneath. bunny's got used to that, then we can take out the treats from the top so that the bun smells the food through the holes underneath, and just simply vary where we place the treats so it keeps it constantly, that keeps the bunny constantly stimulated and looking for food. Whip. There we go. Okay.